Good morning and sairam to all the students. Welcome back in your English online class. So student, today in our grammar chapter we are going to learn one new topic, and this topic name is prepositions. Preposition is also the part of our grammar, and in preposition we learn about the place of noun. So let's start with the definition of preposition. Preposition is a word which is used before a noun phrase or a pronoun, connected it to another word. Basically, preposition tells the place of the noun, pronoun, noun phrase or another word. So what is the easy definition of a preposition? That preposition is a word which is used before a noun phrase or a pronoun, connected it to the another word. In this session, we have three types of preposition. The first preposition is place of preposition. Second, the time of prepositions. Third, direction of preposition. Kinds of preposition, there are mainly three types of preposition. First, place, time, and direction. As I told you, place, time and direction. So one by one we are going to learn this kind of prepositions. Again, place, time and direction. Place, time and direction. Preposition of time. What is preposition of time? Basically, in preposition of time, we use at, on, and, in. At, on, and, in. We use at to designate respective time. For example, the train is due at 12:15 p.m. So, here we know a designated time. So, for designated time, we use at. We use on to designate days or days. Like for all days of week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we use on. My parents are coming on Monday. My parents are coming on Monday. We are having a party on 4th of July. Here also we have designated day or date, 4th of July. So, when we are having a party, 4th of July. We use in for non-specific time during a day, like a month, a season or a year. She likes to jog in the evening. So, why we are using in the evening? Because here we are not giving a specific time. It's too cold in winter to run outside. So here we are not giving a specific date. So we are writing, it's too cold in winter to run outside. He started the job in 1991. So he started a job. Particular, here we are giving a year, 1991. He is going to join in August, but date is not there. So we use in for August. So generally for months, we use in, and for days we use on. Okay, for months we use in, for days we use on. So month like January to December, days Sunday to Saturday. Okay, so in we use for months and on we use for days. Now, look here, there is a, you can say, picture. In we use for year, 1960, monsoon, in October, in the night. On Monday, on Halloween party, on 1st of May. At 5 o'clock, at sunshine, at the moment. So, here we have three uses of in, on, Now with this diagram, you can easily recognize in, on, at, uses of in, on, at. Now, preposition of time, for or since. For or since we had already discussed in one of the exercises of book chapter. Let's see again. Here, preposition of time, for or since. We use for when we measure time in second, minute, hour, days, month or year. Okay, like he held his breath for 7 times. She lived there for 7 years. The British and the Irish have been quarry for 7 centuries. So here we are using for when we have major time. We use since with a specific date or time, like he's worked here since 1970 and he's worked here or she's been sitting in the waiting room since 2:30. So you can see the difference between for and since. In for we have for 7 years, but in since we have specific year 1970. For 7 centuries, since 2:30. So basically since we use when we have a specific date or time. So when we have specific date or time, we use since. Okay. So this is the difference between the since and the for. So if you you have observed that for we have only measure of time, but for since we have a specific time period. So since generally we use when we know the exact time period or a thing. Now the next is place, preposition of place, at, on, and in. So preposition of place we use at for specific address. If you know the specific address of any place, so we use at. Like Grammar English lives at 55 Sham Nagar in Delhi. It's just an example. So we use at for a specific address. We use on to designate names or street or venue. Like her house is on Ring Road. Here we don't know the specific address. We know that her house is on the Ring Road. And we use in for the name of a land area like town, country, state and continents. So continents also we use for in. Like she lives in Dubai. Nagpur is in Maharashtra. Maharashtra state is in India. And one more thing. For small towns we use at. For small towns we use at, like at Haridwar. And for metro cities we use Delhi, like in Delhi. Sorry, we use in, not Delhi. We use in, like in Delhi. So at we use for small towns, small places. And in we use for country, continents and metro cities. So now you know at we use for address and small towns. In we use for countries and specific metro cities. And we use like here, her house is on Ring Road. This is specific for the place. So what are the examples of preposition of place? At, on, in. At, on, in. Now preposition of moment, to and no preposition. So we use to in order to express movement towards the place. They were driving to work together. So here she is going to the dentist's office this morning. So to we are using for something when we are expressing the movement towards some place. Okay, remember this, that to we are using when we are expressing the movement of a person towards a place. Towards and towards are also helpful in preposition express the movement. These are simple variant spelling of the same word. Whichever sounds better to you, we are moving towards the light. This is a big step towards the project completion. So when to, in place of to, sometimes we are using towards also. Towards is a preposition also which shows the expression of movement towards any particular goal or place. With the word home, downtown, uptown, inside, outside, downstairs, upstairs, we use no preposition. Grandma went upstairs. So for that we no need to use grandma went towards upstairs, to upstairs. So these are some words where we no need to use any preposition. Okay, so here we no need to any preposition. Now another is preposition of direction. So place we have done and time we have done. Now preposition of direction. Some prepositions show where something is going. They are called the preposition of direction. Everybody knows the meaning of direction. So the boys chased after each other. So they are telling the direction. The boys chased after each other. The football rolled down the hill. So down the hill, down is a preposition. A man was walking his dog along the river bank. So here is a preposition. The freeway goes right through the city and we are traveling towards the Miami. So these are the words after, down, long, right, toward, which are telling the preposition of the direction. So in the starting I told you we are going to study three kind of preposition today, and we have learnt about the preposition of place, preposition of time and the preposition of direction. You have to learn the words of preposition also, so it will help you in understanding. So there is a small picture to the words preposition. You can see in or inside, the picture is here, on picture is here, at picture is here, near, under picture is here, over picture is here, below picture is here, above picture is here. So these all are the preposition, because preposition basically tell the place of the noun and when it is happening, exactly the place when it is happening, telling about the noun, other words, noun phrasal. So preposition is very helpful in understanding where that particular person is standing. If I ask you, where is your teacher? Or you will say, my teacher is standing in front of me. So in front of me is also a preposition. So today we have learnt about the preposition of time, place and direction. And here it is not a phrasal preposition. We learnt about the single word. In our next video we will learn about phrasal preposition also, group preposition also, like in front of, like this. And meanwhile you learn this preposition. So preposition of time, place and direction. And here is a picture of the preposition to make you more clear. I hope all you have understand this, and just do a practice of these prepositions at home by framing the small sentence and by using these prepositions in your daily life. Thank you and Sairam.